Hi, my name is Terry McMillan, and you're watching RealHarlem.com. Getting to Happy is basically a revisit to women from Waiting to Exhale, who are now pushing 50 and above. And it's about things that you have to learn how to do to recover from any kind of a loss or heartache or disappointment. And things that we, as women, and it doesn't mean it should exclude men, but in this case it's about women, things that we can do to facilitate our own sense of well-being and joy and happiness, but not until after you kind of go through something, so that you ultimately come out ahead emotionally. Make no mistake, I still love him. I just haven't been in love with him for quite some time. It's not an easy thing to admit, and I'm not one of these women who feels like I need a man to complete me. I also don't think that there's just one person in the world meant for you. Sometimes you luck up and sometimes your luck runs out. I'm beginning to wonder if a good marriage is even possible. What I do know is that I'm tired of feeling navy blue when I know I have every right to feel lemon yellow. Ever since I turned 50, I've become more aware of the passage of time and what I'm doing with it. If I drop dead today, what legacy would I leave? Would I have done a lot of the things I wanted to do, seen some of the places I wanted to see, and would I, if I took a few minutes to just think about it, feel as if the time I was blessed with was well spent? Even though I have an interesting job, it still feels like I should be doing more. All I ever wanted was to do something with my life that would have a positive impact on other people, to do something to make us look in the mirror or slow down long enough to see what our behavior really says about us. Mostly our inhumanity, since it leaves red marks. I believe the only way to evaluate how we're living is how we're not living. This is why I'm on a mission, partially, to start doing things that make me feel good. I've made a vow to start eating healthier and exercising on a regular basis because I know better. I'm 25 pounds away from being fat. I don't want to have to start buying all my clothes in Encore at Nordstrom. My goal is to be fit 52 and 62 and 72. I want to feel better than I look. I'm not trying to be a middle-aged centerfold. I just want to look at myself naked and not be disgusted. It may sound naive, but I always thought as you got older, the quality of your life would improve, that things would be smoother, calmer, and you could finally exhale. Only. I'd probably be in the nut house if it weren't for my girlfriends, Bernadine, Gloria, and Robin. 15 years ago, we thought we were hot shit. I was 36 and had just moved here from Denver, where I'd been a publicist for the gas company. Bernadine and her then husband, John, talked me into moving here after a visit when a position in PR opened up in a TV station. The three of us went to Boston University together, and I was her bridesmaid. She worked in finance for a real estate developer and had become a CPA. She introduced me to Gloria, a single parent who had her own hair salon, and Robin, Miss Congeniality. She worked in an executive capacity at an insurance company, but was still on the verge of becoming a slut. After years of our being casualties of love, Gloria is the only one who's happily married. Times have certainly changed. We're all so busy. We don't even hang out like we used to. Don't run our mouths on the phone like half the night the way we used to. Don't gossip about each other the way we used to. We send email or text. Who can be bothered reaching out all day like teenagers? And forget about happy hour. We don't even know if they still have them. We haven't been drunk since 1999. We haven't set foot in a nightclub since Rick James had his last hit.